MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today, we've got a good matchup in store between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Chicago Cubs. Into the box now, Kevin Newman, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. And that'll bring in Adam Frazier. In past meetings with Jose Quintana, just a 3-for-13 batting line. Hit on the ground out to short. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Throw, and he's called out on a close play at first. Next for the Buccos, Ryan Reynolds, who drove in one of his team's two runs in yesterday's game. Now the 1-1 pitch. Drilled to the right side, and that is through into right field for a single.
The first baseman, number 55, Josh.
At the plate now, Josh Bell. It's two balls and a strike to Josh Bell. All even now, 2-2. Reynolds leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. 3-2 now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he fouls this one off. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. So coming to the plate, Javier Baez. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Cubs shortstop with a 3-1 count. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted high and deep into the bleachers and gone. Into the box, Jason Hayward. Hit well again down the right field line, and that'll hit off the ivy out there. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
The third baseman.
Stepping in now, Chris Bryant. Hit hard up the middle. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Wilson Contreras. And a great chance here for the Cubbies to add on in just the first inning. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone, and it's a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that's a fair ball. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from second. At the plate, Anthony Rizzo to 1-2 now. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. So a runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Kyle Schwarber. Now the 1-1 pitch. Two out with the man at first. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
High in the air out to center field. Reynolds has it for out number three. So So the next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Colin Moran. He'll get us started in the top of the second. The 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed, strike three. Settling in now, Gregory Polanco.
The right fielder, Gregory Polanco.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Three balls and a strike to Gregory Polanco. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Fouled away. And another foul ball. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two. Stepping up to the plate, Jacob Stallings. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Took him right up the ladder that time, and it's 1-2.
He's one pitch away from striking out the side, but even more than that, to throw a donut up after your offense put up some runs, I can't tell you what that means to the boys in the dugout.
And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. The next Cub up, Ian Happ, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
It's very difficult being a switch hitter, and very rarely do you see the same hitter from both sides of the plate. He's a far superior hitter from the left side as opposed to the right side.
And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. And as the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. He went deep in the contest last night. The 1-2. Line drive, base hit to right. So now to the plate, Jose Quintana. Tries to get the bunt down here, but this is foul, and we'll see if he tries it again. The 1-2 pitch. And with two strikes, he's able to get this one down. And they'll put the tag on him going to first, but the sacrifice is successful. So in now for Chicago, Javier Baez. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one.
And that last at-bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter. So I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
Well, he just threw that fastball by him. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
34 pitches for him through an inning and two-thirds right now. That's not terrible, but it's a lot higher than he'd like.
And that is through into center field, a base hit. Oh, but it's offline, so the run will score.
Now back, right fielder, Jake Day.
Now a throw over to first, and he'll dive back in safely. Into the box now, Jason Hayward. A little bit outside, 2-1. Smoke toward the hole. And Hayward has a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batted, third baseman, Greg.
To the plate now, Chris Bryant. And it's fouled away. Two men are on with two men out. To two balls and two strikes now.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, 1-2. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get it to him.
And this ball's pretty well struck, high and deep to left field. And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Top of the third set to get underway. Stepping into the box, Cole Tucker. The 1-1 home.
Nope, that's down.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Batting nine.
And now it's the Pirates pitcher, Trevor Williams. And he misses the bunt attempt, so it's a ball and two strikes now.
That's not great form right there, but you can't be surprised. A lot of these guys were not asked to bunt coming up through the minor leagues, so don't expect every sack bunt to get down.
The throw pulls him off the bag, and he's safe. So following the error, it's now runners at first and second, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Kevin Newman. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
A payoff pitch one more time. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And he will somehow keep his eye on the baseball there as he has it for a big out number one.
Now batting.
Here's Adam Frazier. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
A swing and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here. Digging in for his second at bat, Ryan Reynolds. Two on, two out for him here in the third. The 1-2.
Ball, that's out.
Two down, runners at first and second. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And that pitch misses for ball four. So some intrigue now as the bases are loaded here with two away. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Josh Bell. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last time. I'm interested to see if they attack him the same way, come at him with hard velo late, or snap something off in the dirt to see if he'll fish.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Swung on and missed, that strike two. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. Popped up. Rizzo waits on it. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Coming to the plate now, Wilson Contreras. He came through with an RBI single in his last at bat. Hit on the ground to third, reined in. Throw on to first in time, one away. So one away here with the bases empty, and that brings in Anthony Rizzo. And that's down into left center for a base hit. At the plate now, Kyle Schwarber. And there's ball two now.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
Checks his swing, but this will be strike two call. He's set. Here's the 2-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Now the payoff pitch home. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Sent on the ground out to second. Oh, and he can't come up with it. The second for one. Throw on to first won't be in time, so they just get the one there. Now at the plate, Ian Happ 0-for-1 after a pop-out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit.
There's a swing and a drive, and everybody's just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no-doubt home run. Into the box, Jason Kipnis. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
Lots of hits given up, but so far no walks. At least he's making them work to get on base. Problem is, they haven't had to work too hard.
A 3-1 pitch.
Aye. Full count, 3-2.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And up next, the pitcher, Jose Quintana. Two balls and a strike.
And when you're already down five, the last thing you want to do is fall behind in the count when you're on the mound. That's not going to do anything to help you get back into this thing.
2-2. The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. All set for the start of the fourth. So striding forward now, Colin Moran looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
Now batting right fielder.
Stepping in now, Gregory Polanco. Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. Jacob Stallings will be the next hitter. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Takes this the other way to right, and that's going to get down out there, and that'll put him on the board as it's now a 5-1 ball game. And he is into second base with an RBI double.
Now batting, shortstop, Cole Tucker.
So now to the plate, Cole Tucker. Line drive to center field. Half is there, two gone. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Trevor Williams. He comes in 0-for-1 on the day thus far after reaching on an error his first time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Fouled off. The 1-2. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. So it's back to the top of the order now, and with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. Here now the 2-2. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And it's gone as they add still another. In in now, Jason Hayward. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. 6 runs, 9 hits. 1 error for the Cubs to this point. Counts even to Hayward, 2 balls and 2 strikes. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Hayward takes as that pitch misses for ball 4. He'll take the walk.
The third baseman,
Chris Bryant, will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with the runner at first and nobody out.
This guy has been unbelievable. There were billboards outside Wrigley while he was still in AAA, and what does he do when he shows up? Rookie of the year, MVP. I mean, get in line.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Chris Bryant is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. 1-1 home. Runners off for second. Oh, this ball is hammered out to deep center field. And it's gone into the bleachers. At the plate, Anthony Rizzo. Slap hard the opposite way. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. Blake now, Kyle Schwarber, but gloved by the third baseman for the out. Trying to pick things up where he left off. Ian Happ comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier.
Yeah, that last at bat, Daddy, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Throw on to Bell at first, and the side is retired. Ready to go in the top of the fifth. So the Pirates batting order turns over and set to go. Kevin Newman, no hits to this point.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Kipnis ranging into shallow right. He can't get there as it falls in.
Now batter. The left fielder, Adam.
To the plate now, Adam Frazier. 2-2 to Adam Frazier. 1 run, 4 hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. A full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a looper to left. In there, a base hit.
The center fielder, number 10, Brian Reynolds.
Standing in now, Brian Reynolds. And he misses with it, ball 4. So that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball. Trevor McGill is summoned in the toughest situation a reliever can face. Bases loaded, nobody out. Josh Bell will stand in against the new pitcher, and he couldn't ask for a better scenario as he stands in with the bases loaded and nobody out. On the ground for Kipnis, this could be 2. There's 1. Back to first, so they get the double play, but the run does come in to score. So bases empty now after the double play, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Colin Moran. The 1-1 home. Flares this one over toward first. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And the runner from third scores as they try to work their way back into this one.
Now batter, right fielder, Gregory Polanco.
Into the box, Gregory Polanco. Good location on the outside corner there, 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. And he takes ball 3, so it's a full count now.
Well, this has been a good at-bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with 2 away.
Hit out towards second. throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So digging in now, Jason Kipnis. It was a walk in his last trip. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Nico Horner will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. A bouncer up the middle. And there are two away now. And that brings up Javi Baez. One is taken for ball two. Two out, nobody on. Two and two the count. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three. High in the air out to center field. Reynolds has it for out number three. Jeremy Jeffress is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season.
Number 24, Jeremy.
Digging in now, Jacob Stallings. One for two with a double on the ledger so far. Here's the 1-1. He ties him up with a fastball inside, 1-2. Left center, base hit.
The batter, number three, shortstop, Cole Tucker.
So now to the plate, Cole Tucker. This is in the air out to right field. On the move is Hayward. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. In now, Robbie Erlen. He's getting his first plate appearance of the game here in the sixth.
Erlen.
And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. One there. But wisely, no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue.
Now
back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Kevin Newman. He singled his last time up. The 1-2. And he fouls this one off. A runner on first with two away. To two balls and two strikes now.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Struck him out, so he set down on strikes for the second time today. So that'll bring up Jason Hayward. Now the 2-1 pitch. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. Moran stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone.
Now batter.
Digging in once again, Chris Bryant. He went down on strikes last time up. Strike taken up in the zone.
One ball, two strikes,
count. A breaking ball swung on and missed, and he set down for the second time this afternoon. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. So far, two for three in this one.
And in that last at bat, it makes you think this guy might have went up there looking for the breaking ball, because he certainly got a breaking ball, and he didn't miss it. Hit it right on the screws.
Down the left field line and deep, and that will end up a foul ball. Now another 2-2. Ball three. 3-2 now. Now a ball lined toward the alley in left center. So he'll add one to his total as that falls in. He's got three hits in this one. So Anthony Rizzo will have a chance to bat this inning following the base hit. Stepping in now, Anthony Rizzo. Grounded back up the middle. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And a good effort here, but he's well safe at first, and there are two on and two out now.
Now batter, left fielder.
In now, Kyle Schwarber. Fouled away. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time.
Well, giving up hits is one thing, but judging by that last pitch, he doesn't have any consistency with his release point right now. He doesn't know where it's going, and he knows it.
And it's fouled away. A payoff pitch one more time. Fouled off. And he struck him out. A 10-pitch battle, but he finally wears him down as the inning is over. Riding into the box, Adam Frazier. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
A 3-1 count to the left fielder of the Bucks. Brian Reynolds is on deck. Yanked on the ground down the line, but this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. 3-2 pitch. This is on the ground over to first, and that's through into right, so a leadoff single here to start the seventh.
The center fielder, number 10, Brian Reynolds.
To the plate now, Brian Reynolds. Chopped to third, tough to get to. Kipnis. On to Rizzo, but a little slow in developing as they'll just get the one out.
The first base
one away here for the Bucks in their half of the seventh. And digging into bat next, the big bat of Josh Bell. Well hit. Deep down the right field line. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Hit hard towards center. And that's in there, base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
Now back, the third baseman.
At the plate now, Colin Moran. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Runners are at the corners with one man out. And the fastball misses high and away there. It's full 3-2. There's ball four. Rowan Wick is called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Gregory Polanco will be the first to meet him here, and he'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now. From the stretch.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
The 2-1 is looked at off the plate for a ball.
You fight so hard to get into these type of counts. You can't let this pitch get away from you. You have to keyhole something middle of the plate.
And he fouls this one off. Three-two with the bases loaded.
Nope.
And that ball misses. Four. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
The batter.
Into the box now, Jacob Stallings. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. Bases are loaded with only one out. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Center fielder on the run makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And he will score on the sacrifice fly. Now batting, Cole Tucker. And we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home so far this inning. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's two and two.
Well, all of the umpires in the seats thought that was strike three, and they weren't far off, but I think that was a good call. Looked to be just a bit outside.
Full count, three and two. Now the payoff pitch home. Hit in the air down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. Down the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. Three and two. Payoff pitch one more time. It is swung on and missed. Strike three.
Please join us with the traditional seven-inning stretch.
Michael Feliz will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Luke Maley will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch.
Number 14.
The 3-1 pitch takes a strike for a full count now. 3-2.
3 balls, 2 strikes.
High pop up. Moran is there for it. Makes the play, one away. Ready for another chance? Jason Kipnis, a hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. And he pops him up, drifting toward the left side of the infield. Feliz with a little do-it-yourself play, and there are two down. Victor Caratini will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number seven, Victor Caratini.
Ball's headed for the gap in left center. He's got a base hit, possibly more. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two base hit.
The batter number nine, shortstop, Javier.
Into the box now, Javier Baez. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez. On the ground, back up the box, and it'll get through into center field, a base hit. The relay, the throw, and he's tagged out at second. That'll end the inning, but they do score one on the play. Ryan Tepera will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far.
Number 52, Ryan.
Into the box, Luke Maley. Fouled away. He'll try again, 1-2. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down. Striding in, Kevin Newman. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Two balls and a strike, here it comes. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Kipnis is calling for it, and that's the second out of the inning. Digging in and looking for more, Adam Frazier. Two hits in four attempts to this point. Bases are empty here with two men out. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series.
And the shortstop is under it to make the play, retiring the side. Nick Birdie is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 57.
Now to the plate, Jason Hayward. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. So one gone here in the Chicago eighth. And into bat next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Kyle Ryan comes on from the pen, now hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Stepping into the box, Ryan Reynolds. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Ryan is among a dying breed, those lefty specialists whose roles are changing with the new rules around reliever usage. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. Josh Bell the next to hit. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. A ball and two strikes now. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
Their count now at 2-2. Here it comes. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Colin Moran waits on deck. Lifted down the line and left. And no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Another full count offering on its way. Now a swing and a ball lofted down the right field line and fairly deep. Hayward is out near the wall as he pulls it in for the second out. Digging in to try it again, Colin Moran. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three. Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line, and no one will track it down. Pittsburgh down to their last strike. Hit high but foul as that'll get in amongst the fans. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves now a two-out base runner.
Gregory Polanco.
The 1-1 home. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder giving chase. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Always it's nice to get the first game of the series, but even more so when it's in front of the home crowd, seems to energize everybody the rest of the series.
This one comes to a close with a 9-5 final. The Cubbies jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Trevor McGill claims the win out of the pen, his first. Trevor Williams was hit hard to the tune of 7 earned as he takes the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 9 runs on 15 hits. 1 error, they left 8 runners on base. For the Pirates, 5 runs on 9 hits. No errors, they left 10 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 42 minutes. Our paid attendance at Wrigley Field this afternoon, 41,649. As always, we thank you for your support of Chicago Cubs baseball and remind you to please drive home safely.